Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome back to another video. I want to welcome you back, and this is going to be a little practice for me for future vlogs. Now, I've got this little series that I'm going to do leading up to my fight on November 19th, if it falls through and if it goes through. So this is going to be a little practice thing, just a little day in the life thing, little vlog, just trying out a few new things, trying out a little new edits, a little new footage and whatnot. Let's see if you guys like it, all right? Let's do a little bit of a switch, a little bit of a different switch. Ready? Let's do it.
Check this out. Not bad yet. So we're gonna try something like this, guys. I strapped the GoPro to my chest and we're gonna try a few things like this. Let's see it.
Alright guys, so I was super keen and really wanted to try this GoPro footage going on right now, but I got the equipment, I invested in the equipment, the accessories, but the camera isn't too great. I mean, it gets the job done, but as opposed to my iPhone quality camera, the camera quality isn't too great. And the audio, as you just heard before, is absolutely, like, not trash, but there's better out there. So I may need to invest in an actual GoPro in the future. So that's why I decided to cut out all the audio footage. I actually had a lot more to do with the GoPro that I did, but I made sure to cut it out so everything can flow a lot more nicely. I did more quick, sharp point edits. Now, I'm gonna be freestyling over this video, guys. It's not gonna be anything too structural. Yeah, I'm just gonna be talking over it, update you guys on a few little things, things that I've been trying, and we'll see how we go. Now, as you guys saw, I was preparing my food and everything from the day before so I can go to training, get all my calories, all my foods, everything that I need ready for tomorrow so I don't have to stress about it in the morning. So I normally like to blend up like a nice peanut butter smoothie or like just some type of smoothie with frozen berries that my dietitian has recommended for me that I've been following. So I try to prepare that and I pack one of my main meals for the day. So I take them two along with me, and there's actually an awesome facility at Absolute where I can just heat it up, keep everything there, and just easily put it away and eat it. So yeah, I've been traveling by train and bus as of recently because unfortunately your man's lost his license. So it's a bit of a curb for me, but there's some instances where it's like, if I had it, it would have been a lot more better. It's definitely a lesson learned. Like, there's some scenarios where I really, what's the word for it? Take for granted, I guess. You know, there's situations where something will come up and I'll urgently need to go, but I can't because I don't have a car on me. But in some instances, it's okay. Like, I've been able to travel to the city pretty smoothly. Like, I don't have to run into traffic. There's no stop, start or anything. The only problem with this is sometimes there's train delays. So I'm always on the app Mover. So I'm keeping track of everything as much as I can, making sure that there's no delays or anything like that. Because if there is, stuffs my whole trip up. But so far, every single time I've traveled to the city or St. Kilda, it's been a very smooth trip. So here I'm going to Absolute MMA in Collingwood. I do my first session over there. It's a bit of a journey, I'm not gonna lie, but I normally either listen to a podcast or I actually just chuck in some tunes and I just chill. Or if there's some things I need to check off or some errands that I need to do on my phone, message clients or anything like that, I get that done on the way. Plus, I just been to watch a bit of YouTube as well. It's a bit of a great way for me to catch up because I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty chaotic for me, my scheduling. So I get to catch up on a few things like that. And that stop that I just passed, I swear to God, I cut it out. But I genuinely waited a solid 10 minutes to cross that darn stupid road. Generally took ages. But yeah, I needed to walk a little bit to catch the bus, and some, like, it's just normal public transport. You come across some stupid idiots, especially now that, like, I'm close to the city and all that. You just come across some weird people and whatnot. Check this out. Look, it's got those full stares at me, bro. I don't know. People ask me questions after, it's like, oh, what's the thing on your chest and all? I get some funny looks, but yeah. I'll catch up with you guys in a sec.
Alright, so from here is when I'll go into class. Just before class, because I'm here a bit early, I'll get changed, warm up, stretch and whatnot. And there was something that I started my day off pretty nicely with. I'll share it on screen right now. Little thing to just motivate me, get me going for my day.
Those times when you get up early and you work hard. Those times when you stay up late and you work hard. Those times when you don't feel like working, you're too tired, you don't want to push yourself, but you do it anyway. That is actually the dream. That's the dream. It's not the destination, it's the journey.
I try to keep my feed algorithms pretty clean with stuff like that, because stuff like that's really, really a good way to put myself in a good mood and boost myself to start my day off right.
Alright, so this is the setup. Got my change of clothes, changed everything, got my equipment. Now we're gonna go stretch and train.
Hey, you gotta admit, the setup's not too bad, eh? Gets me in and out pretty quick, so I've got everything ready to go before I start training and after I finish training.
Little question for you all. Do you like to stretch before training or after training? Let me know in the comments.
Genuinely, please do let me know in the comments, because I've seen and heard a few individuals that don't like to stretch before training, but they have a big emphasis after training and stretching. I always stretch before training, obviously, to loosen up my muscles, but I've heard it's really, really good to stretch afterwards. So please, in the comments below, do let me know. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts. And if you guys do have any questions, shoot it in the comments, ask it. Not only can I ask, but maybe some of the subscribers or the other viewers can ask it too.
That was a tiring session. Shower time, man. Session recap. Got to work on a few things that I wanted to work on. Got to work on a bit more of the head positioning on some of the grappling exchanges that I do. But overall, a very, very good session. I learned a lot from today. Pushed hard mentally, one of those mentally draining sessions, but I pushed through. I like to do these reflections at the end of the sessions, anything that I do, to make sure that like I absorb as much as I can. You know, I don't want to go in without a good perspective into my sessions. I like to go in with learning a few things, you know? So I'll look back, think about these things, and improve on it. I pulled one of the biggest L's. My AirPod battery finished. So for this whole trip back, I'm gonna have to listen to no music, no videos. Biggest drainer, biggest mistake. I should have been charging it as of last night. Look at me, I'm like a full-fledged YouTube vlogger, bro. GoPro, all this, that. Oh, what am I doing, bro? But now what I'll do is I'll start heading back to my areas, getting ready for the second training session at XFC. But on the way back, again, like as I was eating, I was reflecting, thinking about like what I did, what things I need to work on. And now I'll really reflect. I'll look up a few things on the like on the train, whether it's footage or if something interesting pops up, I'll watch it. I'll use this time to try and fix up my game and whatnot. Then like what I like to do is to try those things out at the gym. Now, the people that I was training with before already know all these moves. So when I go and try it out at my home gym at XFC, we're gonna actually see if it works and whatnot and if it actually suits my style. And then from there, I pick and choose and I rip apart a few things and I full level up my character, level up me. So let's make the switch. I'm gonna go from this to this. Let's make the switch.
I'd just also like to say, excuse the way my appearance has been looking as of recently. I haven't been focusing on myself in that manner. I've been really focusing on the fight, focusing on training. I haven't shaved, I haven't cut my hair. I've been looking after myself externally. I've been focusing mentally and internally a lot, but I will be sure to get a haircut and structure myself a bit more better this week onwards.
Honestly, now when I look at it, like, it's a lot faster to go by transport like this, whether it's bus, trains, as opposed to a car. I remember it takes me like hour and a half to 2 hours to get to here with the traffic on the freeway, whereas this, train smooth, bus pretty smooth. So honestly, this is actually pretty faster than what I normally take. And for some of you thinking, you're going all that way by bus, you're going all that way by train, then you're gonna train again later on tonight, you see, with all these top other individuals, if you wanna make that, if you wanna get good and you wanna get great, you make that sacrifice and you make that trip. Do I feel tired? Yes. Do I feel drained? Yes. Do I get sore as fuck? Yes. But it's all about mentally being strong and surrounding yourself with like-minded individuals. Like, I'm pumped up, I'm happy. I've got something to look forward to, which is my fight. Always gotta have something to look forward to. Put yourself in the uncomfortable. As I said in the last day in the live video that I did, seek comfort in the uncomfortable. You've got to make it exciting. You've got to feel that element of pressure here and there, but it's a lot of fun. And for some of you that will be asking, what's this? That's stuff. Yes, it's on the healing process, but I'll step it in my opponent's face. I'll put it in his face, get him infected and whatnot. But yeah, it's just a little thing. It's on the heel. It's almost healed. Antibiotics that are killing me. Quick tip, if you guys ever have staff and you're on antibiotics, just expect to feel fatigue. You'll probably do your sparring session, you'll gas out in 3 rounds, which is what happened to me. So antibiotics hit you hard.
I'd also like to say thank you for everyone viewing the Coles video that I posted up recently. Like, that's actually popped off and done pretty well. I've been getting like a few direct messages and I've been hearing a lot of great things from that video. So just like that Coles video, if you guys have any questions or inputs or anything, legit, just shoot in the comment below. Like, I like it. I like how we're actively talking. You know, you guys are getting some insightful information and whatnot off me, or you're just learning a few things. And some individuals that don't know anything at all, just learn from it. By the way, this view here is pretty sick from Richmond train station. You just see the city really, really nicely. And what you're about to see is me literally finding out that my fight got announced on social media and my actual reaction to it. So enjoy.
So my fight just got announced. What do I feel? A bit of nervousness, excite. Nervous, excitement, adrenaline. I feel all these things right now. Like, it's like my heart race for like the first minute. It's like, shit, it's happening. It's happening. Guys, I had five opponents, all of them canceled, pulled out, or just couldn't make the fight. This one actually is going through, and this is gonna be a great name for me and a great test for me. How do I feel with this matchup? I feel confident. I'm keen, I've been training really hard. Keen to see how much I've improved, you know? Yeah, keen to see how much I've improved, and I believe I'll be able to defeat this guy. I've been training with straight killers, people that are professionals, people that are up there, trained with the best, been around the world. And I'm really keen because I feel like this is going to push my name out there. This guy is known as a judo black belt and he's fought in the Olympics. So I'm really keen, really, really keen, and I have faith in my abilities and I have faith in my training. And if I just keep on doing what I'm doing right now and I keep on training hard like I am right now, there's no way this guy's going to defeat me. No way. I'm keen for a pump show. I'm keen, if I open up the card, I'm keen to open up the card. I'm keen to see all my other people that I train with on the same card, because I'm fighting under the same card as many, many people, which is the most coolest part, you know? Like, after you're done with your fight, you get to see the individuals that you train with, that you know, that they fight, and you egg them on to. But yeah, I'm really keen for this fight. This is good. This is good. I guess I'm just pondering my mind right now. Pondering my mind. Feeling keen. There's no turning back now. There's no turning back now. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'm ready. I'm ready. I feel ready for this fight. Striking. Feel confident. If it goes to the crown, I got it. I feel good. I feel good. I feel great. Diet's been going great too. No complaints. I'm fucking ready. This is sick. This is gonna be a good show. I have a good feeling about this. It's gonna be good.
All right, this will be the last portion of me actually talking over these little videos. So I'd also just like to say, in these future videos that I got planned before the week of my fight, that I obviously won't be posting until after I complete the fight, because I don't want my opponent to know anything. But I'm actually gonna have videos of me training, like actually doing the sessions, whether it's hitting pads or whatnot, me mentally, how I walk around, how I feel. I'll be talking into the camera. So some of these footages here will have a lot more entertaining content. I just can't put it in right as of now because I don't want my opponent to find out too much, but I'm super stoked and keen. Like, I'm genuinely really keen for this competition. I hope nothing happens to my opponent the lead up to the fight, but I'm ready. I'm really ready, I'm really keen, and I've been envisioning everything from the start.
A weird combination for you all to try. The Chobani Yo Pro. You get your fork and you get like a nice spoon, fork, like a scoop. You get your apple, you stab it in, and you open your big mouth, and you just eat it. My last food before training, rice cakes. This one will have strawberry jam, and this one will have the peanut butter. I just do like a sandwich. Chuck them on top, push down, and then chuck this one on top. One hand is actually very difficult. And push down. Boom. Oh shit!
Check them out.
Not bad.
Selam. Naber?
Naber.
Ne gets naber? Evet. Gel.
Alo.
Sparring class done. Hard training session. Pushed through. Got to work on a few things that I've been working on, which is great. All these things that I've been trying at the first place I trained at, Absolute. It's all working. So I'm fucking happy that it's all coming to a T. Just, I gotta keep that consistency up. 1 to 2 more weeks of hard training like this, and then from there, I can move on, take it a bit more lower the training a bit, but I'm keen to push forward, bro, keen to push forward. Everything's working. Come, Jaden. I don't know if you can see. Come around the
block.
Hello. How are ya?
Hey.
I like your shirt. It's fucking hot.
Get ready for Christmas.
Yeah? Christmas spirit in November. That's it. Still got one more month, bro. Mr. Jaden Wright, OG in the game. But yeah, that's sparring done. Now I'll work on my own things, work on the heavy bag, a few kicks that I want to practice, and then from there we've got class to teach.
And that's the vlog done. I hope you guys enjoy. This is practice for me, remember, but like and subscribe.